I can't abuse all my bullets.
This can't be happening. Think you can just walk in here? After all these years, it's silk sheets and Parisian whores from now on, mister. What the goddamn hell is this? A glass eye?
I'm sure whoever that belonged to treasured it very much.
Stupid liars. Those stupid chicken shit maps. Making a damn fool of me. A glass eye! It's a glass eye!
Stop with the tears and help me with Williamson's gang. And you can come up with another excuse to go exhume one of your old friends.
Hunting dead man's treasure ain't done me no favors. Sure. Sure. I'm ready for the living. I'll see you and Mr. West Dickens over at Fort Mercer when you gentlemen is ready.
this steed looks right fetchy, I don't mind telling. Good luck, son. He's a wild one, and no mistake. And slow down! Don't move. You'll be moved. Just calm yourself. Just stay there. That's it. Stay calm. Nearly there. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, here we go.
Mr. Marston, how are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend, Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead. Yes, interesting fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. Wes Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull, feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America, that lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon. Extra hands. And I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No. The sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating degenerate like myself can prosper. Come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive. Now, sir, two gap tooth breach. Seth is an interesting fellow, is he not?
I wouldn't say interesting. More deeply disturbed. I can see why you could get along.
I see the good in everybody, John. It's a far cry. I have a soft spot for
Wilson. Connection with him, more like. You and Seth have a lot in common. Both rob people, for one. Mind you, at least he waits until they're dead.
Oh, my dear boy. Nobody is more critical of drinkers than a drunk who's mended his ways.
What are you talking about?
Come on now, John. I've heard about you. You spent your life robbing people. It's a little inappropriate to be taking the moral high ground now.
I had the courtesy to put a gun in their face.
Whatever helps you sleep easily at night.
We stole from those who had too much. Tried to give to those who had too little.
A Robin Hood with spurs. Oh, romantic. You're expecting to believe that poppycock. Maybe I'll have the good fortune to be able to leave my nefarious life behind one day and work on the government's dime.
Don't talk about things you don't understand.
Dear, simmer down, my boy. You need to start appreciating your friends more. Folks around here don't see you as any different from Bill Williamson.
I didn't think I'd have to huckster snake oil and dig up the dead, that's all.
Take it from me, John. Collaboration is the key to success. I can help you. Seth can help you. It's business. Nothing more, nothing less. There's no need to make it quite so personal.
Suits me.
Thank you. I'm raised, mister. I'll take care of this cart for Mr. Wes Dickens.
Come on, John. I suggest we beat a hasty retreat. Right. Best remove ourselves from the stage before somebody decides they want their money back.
Fine by me.
Isn't that fantastic? The cheers of the crowd, the thunder of the wheels.
The falling rocks, the homicidal maniac.
Oh, come on, John. Even a cold-hearted misanthrope like you must have found that just the tiniest bit exhilarating.
Not the friendliest bunch, are they?
They take the racing very seriously in these parts, and your participation was not entirely free of food.
That was clear.
Ah, sport, bore, and heartache. The guilty pleasures of mankind since the dawn of time.
I'd get away from the men we just swindled before you start waxing too lyrical.
Yes, yes, of course.
Sir, well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
What you got on you, friend?
Thank you.
will fetch a good price.
Well, I'm not really in a buying mood, but I guess I'll take a look. A fine choice. My products are of the finest quality, sir.
I'll be back with more next time I pass through.
Please come again.
What's the rush there?
You don't bump.